Hey there, everybody. Back again. Same shirt, but another video. This is the third video I'm making today. They're going to be broadcast over the 3 weeks while you already watched the previous two. I almost forgot about this one. My lone eBay pickup was a pinball arcade on the PS4. It does not have the other tables. I don't know. It says they're not released yet or something. I was hoping to get, you bought the game, you get every single table, but I guess that's not true. And I don't know if they're going to be releasing them later or what on a PS4. I did not have this on the PS3. I downloaded, but I have FX2 on the 360, and then I have the Williams Hall of Fame on the 360. So I didn't want to buy them four tables at a time because, like, the first table pack was like $10, and it had Arabian Nights and Taxi, I think, which I already have. So I wanted to buy them in a bundle like this, and I was hoping that I would have had every single one, but apparently they're going to be releasing more Love Pinball games. The next two were also, like I said the previous week, were on the same garage sale site, same day. I picked them up yesterday, actually. And I'll show you the one I got hosed on first. It is a silver GameCube. I paid $40 for it, and the only reason I paid $40 for it was because of the game that came with it. But I assumed they were, let me see if I can get this bag open here, complete, and they were not. So, it comes with a generic, an off-brand, and this person was a gamer too, I could tell, some girl. She kept trying to undercut me on some of these deals I was making. I was the one that put in search of. So, yeah. I mean, this controller is generic and it feels cheap. It comes with both cords. It was originally going to be a black one, she said, but she said her black one wasn't working for some reason. So that's why I can tell she's a gamer. If you got more than one. And, oh, gosh, this smells like smoke bad. Ugh. Terrible. All the games are loose. And I even checked the condition. Oh, they're in bad shape. I really got hosed. Animal Crossing, this is one of the reasons I bought it. I figured my wife would like this game. It's got this big old scratch on the back. I might be able to go get them resurfaced. I just really don't know if it's worth it. It only came with three games. No, it should have been more than that. She hosed me even further. She only gave me three games. There's another one that's supposed to be, that was like, okay, I'll spend $40 on it. Lord of the Rings, Return of the King, and Battalion Wars. And all games are in bad condition. I won't be dealing with her again. She keeps posting game stuff on there. I won't be buying stuff. She can suck it. So $40, you win some, you lose some. Next thing, I'm going to do like my previous video. This is the Epic score. I paid $140 for these two boxes here. A lot of the stuff is common, so let's get that out of the way. I haven't dug through it all, so I don't really know what's here, but we'll find out. So, I got these NES games. Beat the heck. These are dirty too. Cool. Some of them are cool, a lot of them I don't have. So, we got, just keep in mind, all this is $140. I got Demon Sword. I think I already have this one. I got Zanek. I do not have this one. I think this is a shooter. Wayne F., I got your game. Karnov. I've been wanting to get Karnov for a while. I go to my favorite retailer, and like I said many times before, they got this big display case, and I just, by the time I get to it, I already picked out my quote unquote or close to my limit, what I want to spend a week. I don't really have a limit. She lets me buy pretty much whatever I want. So she says she trusts me and she loves me. She lets me buy things. So, but I always try to keep it reasonable and make sure we can pay the bills and put a little away and stuff. But every time I get to there, I'm like, I'll find something else for Sega related, so I always pass up on Karnov. And they have this big, huge, two big display cases with all these NES games. I'm actually going to try to get Scott from JDM HF. He's coming to town, I think, next month with Corn to my town, and he'll probably tear up that case because there's a lot of games in there, and they're decent prices. So, but like I said, I always run out. I don't feel like going through the case, and so I usually pass on that case. And then I got Top Gun Second Missions. I didn't know they made a second mission. The first game was crappy. Don't have that one. The proverbial Super Mario Duck Hunt, the most common game in the world. Xenophobe, glad to have this. I like the arcade game. A lot of people don't. I like this. So. Then we got Super Spike V-Ball World Cup Combo. I don't think I have this. So, glad to have that. And Josh, I got your game. And then Monster Truck Rally. I know I don't have that. That's pretty cool. The BitTokai game, it looks like. Well, who is it made by? I can't see. It's all... Invitech. INTV. NTV Court. Never heard of this game, actually. So. And then a Beat the Heck Super Mario 2. It's got a crack there. I hope there's no spiders living in there. That'd suck. So. I'm sure it works, though. I already have that game. The Legend of Zelda, I don't know if he was digging with it or what. I mean, I'm sure this works too, but it's not in the best shape. Already have that. And then the Guardian Legend, which I'm pretty sure I have, and I'm sure this, I think this is a misleading, this is a shoot 'em up. Even though it has nothing to do with the title, I think this is a shoot 'em up. And then another very common game made by Taito. It's Wrath of the Black Manta. Okay, and I think that's all. Wait, I don't have a box here. Here's another copy of Super Mario Duck Hunt. And I actually just was buying the NES games of a lot. So let me go and show you. He said he went ahead and threw in a... Went ahead and threw in an NES here. Kind of dirty. We'll see if it works. Wow, what the heck kind of deal is that? Looks like he has a adapter, you know, universal. No bonus games. So, RF Switch. It's just weird. Well, we'll give it a try and see if it works. I'll probably keep this as a backup because I don't have a backup NES if it does. Working here as well. I actually almost thought this was a real gun, but it looks like a generic NES light gun. I've never seen anything like this. I don't know who makes this. Anyone knows what this is, let me know. It's a zapper. Well, nope, it's for the Genesis. Never seen it before. Let me know what this is, guys. I have no idea. And I'm a Genesis freak. Okay, it came with one dirty controller. Looks like it's spraying there. Another controller. I don't know how people, when they put stuff away, they don't just they just throw the stuff in the box. Drives me freaking insane, man. I mean, that my stuff will sit in boxes till I get to it and then put it away, which could be months. But still, put your stuff away neatly. All right, and then I also purchased it for he said he didn't have for Model 2 Genesis. He said he didn't have the, what is this stuff? This might be the adapter he had. I'm going through it. Could be. This probably works on the Super Nintendo or the NES. We'll see. He said he didn't have, it didn't have the adapter to it. For the Genesis, the AC adapter, but this is it. So glad to have that. Maybe it was the RF switch he was talking about. Anyway, there we go. And so, let's see, we got one controller, two 3-button controllers here. Sorry, this stuff is, it would have taken me longer to organize it and then show it than us just going through it together. Like we're friends and we're all excited together because we get to see what we got. It comes with all these games here. Nothing spectacular, a lot of loose ones. NFL Football 94, don't know if these are complete. Not even in there. So, this is an NFL Football 94 case, which I actually like that game. RBA Baseball 94, which I think I have this one too. Oops, sorry, didn't mean to hit the camera there. Mortal Kombat 2, not complete. Have it already anyway. Tecmo Super NBA Basketball. Not complete, but have it already. Alright, let's go through the release games here. Oh, it looks like one more 3-button controller. Mix them up here. I'm going out of frame, not very well organized, but you guys get over it. Vector Man Beat the Crap cart here. Vector Man, have it already. Oh, here's the NFL Football 94. So it's the only one complete game I have. Dirty as heck. Monopoly, which I have loose, I think. Miss Pac-Man, which I have complete. I think I have all these games, and that really sucks. Sonic 2, the not for resale version. NBA Jam Tournament Edition. I have really no use for loose carts unless it's something valuable and then I can try to complete it on the backside, other way around, or at least get the box. There's nothing jumping out at me here. Street Fighter, the Special Championship Edition. I don't know if I have that, but it doesn't matter. It's not complete. Super Battleship, I have actually a brand new copy of that. Zoop, I know I have that complete. A few more here. The 6-pack, which I have complete. This is not for resale version, though. Sonic Classics includes... this I do not have. Sonic Classics includes 3 great Sonic games. I don't have that. And then these two are probably the 2 best games in the bunch. I have them both complete. And it looks like a Dog Chewed Road Rash. And a Road Rash 2. So, nothing spectacular. Oh wait, what is this? I wish this was, it's just a loose copy of NFL Club, Quarterback Club 97. It's in a Legend Oasis case, with not the manual, but the backside. I wish it was that, because I need this game. Yes, I would like it to be this. There is a loose disc game over here. Oh, it's the Administrative Professional, whatever, trash. So, there's that, not worth anything. But the reason I bought it, ladies and gentlemen, is one, for an original, not the Model 2, Atari Lynx. Dirty as heck, but I did test it out. The batteries are still in there. Yes, they are. And we'll power this on. It's coming. And you can barely see it says California Games on there. Because of the California Games disc in there. And it's loud as heck. So the speaker is in good shape. So I finally got Atari Lynx back, and that is annoying. So Atari Lynx. And then the PS2 Resistance, something I've wanted my whole life. A Sega Nomad. And it does work. Works good, actually. The battery pack, it doesn't have a battery pack from what I hear. There's only a way to mod the battery packs, even if you find a new in-box battery pack. The lithium or whatever batteries they used back then will be toast. So there's a way to modify it, but I'm just glad to have a Nomad. So my kids are in there hogging the TVs. I can just bring out an adapter and be like, let's play some Genesis handheld. Yeah. I'm happy. So, $140. I may have overspent a little bit. Now going through the box and seeing what's here. But I'm just happy to have an Atari Lynx and a Sega Nomad. I can see if the Genesis works. Sell it with this lot of games. I have no use for that Platinum GameCube. So we'll see if that works, and I might give it to my brother or sell it. Smells like cigarette ass butt. So, yeah, we'll see what. So, that's it. Now, hopefully, I'll be ahead on videos. I still gotta edit them, but I can edit them at my leisure. Get the one edited today, so it will be posted tonight, and then hopefully every Saturday or Sunday I will have a new one up, and maybe we can do this on a weekly thing instead of a when I get time thing, which is never. So appreciate you guys for watching, and thanks a lot.